Now, what are the systemic effects of aging? I want to go this slide, you please see as a bidirectional model. Don't see as a unidirectional model. Whatever I'm talking right now is not the effects of aging. I want to say that if you see anybody like this, he's aging. Forget the age part from your mind. Don't even look for. We have seen this movie, Pa. Amitabh Bachchan was, I think, 12 years of age. He had progeria. So he was aging faster, right? So systemic consequences of aging can be clustered into four main domains of age, of the process. First, the body composition. Everywhere, it's the body composition which is talked the first. Whether we talk academic body composition, we talk commercial. So obesity management currently, I think, is on the boom. So out of the four main domains, one is body composition, like body weight, BMI, fat mass, waist circumference, which keeps on increasing. Second is the balance between energy availability and energy demand. Third is the signaling networks that maintain homeostasis. And very important here are the neurotransmitters, hormones, inflammatory mediators, and antioxidants. And I think anti-aging is working a lot on this third point. So a lot of things are done on hormone side, a lot of things are done on neurotransmitter side. I think in US some pharmacies are coming with some neurotransmitter supplement, and some labs have come with neurotransmitter testing from your saliva and urine. And the fourth is the neurodegeneration. If we see this slide, the waist circumference, as per the gerontology, as per the geriatric medicine, it keeps on increasing till the adult life, and then it remains the same, or it keeps on increasing even after that, in spite of the loss of the body weight. Because after a certain age, your lean mass goes down, so your body weight goes down, but your waist circumference keeps on increasing because of the visceral deposition of fat, and this is the visceral deposition of fat which is a big problem.